Hey guys, welcome to a new SciCraft mini-series. So in episode 0 today, I want to introduce to the challenge and will also prepare our playground a little bit. So let me explain what this idea is about. Methods proposed a while ago that we could do a vanilla playthrough of the game, but with a very limited amount of space. So he proposed that we would have 3x3 chunks available and we would need to do everything in that area. So we would have a world border. And I think it would be kind of interesting if you would start in a very desolate place where we don't have a lot of resources available, like a desert or a badlands biome. I think the journey from starting with nothing to a thriving Minecraft society will be quite interesting. There will also be a lot of challenges involved. So for example, if you would start in a badlands biome with just a very limited amount of space, you wouldn't have trees available. So the first challenge would be to get tools so we can think a bit faster than punching with our fists. So we could get sticks if we punch the dead bushes around here. Then if we dig down a little bit, eventually we'll uncover some stone. And if we get a creeper to spawn, could blow up that stone, we would get cobble. In this way we could craft our first pickaxe, for example. But of course, since we don't have trees, we still need a crafting table. So we need to start with a crafting table for sure. And then later, we could also get saplings from the wandering trader. We could get all tree types this way, but we would need emeralds first. So we need to convert a zombie villager into a villager and so on. So it's definitely possible to start in such an area here. Okay, we also need to do some testing. So I set a world border here at 400 minus 250. I wonder the world border in the nether dimension is gonna be. Okay, so I adjusted it correctly. So we will also be able to go to the nether. So I was thinking we could maybe start with one lava source here in the area. We could buy dripstone from a wandering trader. So this way we can definitely get to the nether eventually. Okay, next question is, where's the world border in the end dimension though? Okay, so we would end up here and no world border to be seen. Oh wait, it's actually over here. Okay, is it the same coordinates as the overworld? Yeah, it looks like it. So we definitely want to be able to go to the end, but the world border basically would need to be here centered around the dragon fight, because if you're that far out from the world border in survival mode, yeah, you take a lot more damage than if you're just a little bit outside of the world border. So you could maybe get some ender pearls real quick to show you this effect. So the further away you are from the world border, the more damage you take. So the way to get out of the world border is obviously ender pearls. You can also get back. So here, survival, you can definitely survive for a couple seconds, but if you go further out, then you take a lot more damage. Okay, so I think it would be best then if you search for a seed with a Badlands biome at 0-0, so the world border in the end dimension would also be at 0-0. I'm not an expert on that stuff. I just looked through the commands here, so I'm not sure if there is a way to have it a different location in the end dimension compared to the overworld. But I can just search for a seed, we don't have the problem. After going through a couple hundred chunks, I found one that I really like. So it's mostly badlands, a little bit of desert here on the side. And I decided that I want to make this a 4x4 chunk challenge, because then the world border matches the 4x4 chunks almost perfectly. Fortunately, it's not a perfect match. So you can see the 0-0 point where the world border is centered on. On one side, we basically got one extra row of blocks, actually on two sides. And here it would match with the board of the chunk perfectly on this side and that side. Fortunately, so I set it to 65, I set it to 64, then everything just moves half a block over. So it seems like we can't really the perfect world border just around 4x4 chunks. We just have this extra row. Okay, then I also checked underground already. There's not much available that we could work with. Definitely gonna add a geo to this and just move one over a couple of blocks. I don't think that's gonna be a problem, so we got something to do. Also thinking we could maybe add a skeleton spawner to this. But apart from that, no caves. This is pretty good, because that means we don't have access to dripstone. We need to get a dripstone from a wandering trader. This will be basically, yeah, the way we get to the nether dimension. So of course, with the dripstone and a source of lava and a cauldron, you can make more lava, which can be turned into obsidian. This way you can get to the nether. Right, speaking of the nether, let's check this out. So this is quite an interesting nether we got available here. At first, I didn't know what was going on. But it seems like it's like fully filled up with blocks. We are in a basalt delta biome, and it's just completely filled here with blocks. So only on the side here, we got a little bit of an opening. I think there's also a little bit of nether waste biome here on the side. It's kind of important for mob spawning, so we could get zombified piglins from here. But most of it is really a basalt delta biome. I'm also thinking about maybe adding nylium block, warped and crimson, so we can also get the nether trees. And we could maybe add two piglins somewhere, so we can also do some bartering. But apart from that, yeah, there's not much available in the nether. Unfortunately, the nether fortress is just a couple blocks outside. I definitely do want to get wither skeletons, so we could maybe move the structure inside as well. That's possible somehow. Okay, last thing to check is the end dimension. I haven't been there at all yet. Let's see how this looks. Okay, so we're definitely gonna start outside of the world border. And then somehow we need to make our way over there. So I'm not entirely sure yet how that's gonna work, because if we end up here, I think we have like two damage ticks and we're dead. I definitely like this challenge of trying to get to the middle of the end island somehow. So the first idea that I had was drop some TNT through the end portal and then ender pearl after that. And as soon as you would go to the end, it would shoot your ender pearl to the middle of the end island. This would be rather complicated because you need to get everything right. But I think there might be an easier one. If we start with turtles, we could throw Potion of the Turtle Master through the portal, which I actually failed here. Let's try it again, because then you get resistance 4 and you take a lot less damage. See if I can get the throw right. Okay. Because as far as I know, if you go through the end portal, you would lose your status effects. Yeah, let's try it in survival. Then we just get some golden apples and ender pearls ready. This way, we might make it. So let's see. We got the status effect. Quickly, I'm gonna eat some golden apples. Ender pearl, keep eating golden apples. Oh my god. Ender pearl again, golden apple, and now we're actually so close to the world border, we don't take a ton of damage anymore, and we made it inside. Okay, this would be one way, yeah, we could get here. Now I'm getting killed by the Enderman, it's unfortunate. Okay, but it's definitely possible. Alright, I added a couple more additions to the world. Let's just go through it step by step. So here down at minus Y40, I added a little bit of greenery. Some glow berries, so we can also have access to those, because the wandering trader wouldn't sell those. There's also one spore blossom. Here we got the two high flowers, so we can also get those. And here we actually got a little bit of a jungle biome around some moss carpet and grass blocks here. The grass blocks are kind of important, so we could also get some flowers if we let's just place them down and bone mill it. And because this is a jungle biome, you could get bamboo from fishing. You wouldn't get that from any other biome. So bamboo is important, so we can get some scaffolding later. Other items we can mostly get from a wandering trader, cocoa beans, etc. But we also added an end portal frame here at the bottom of the world, so we will be able to get to the end dimension from there. Then I moved a geode inside of the area, so we also got that covered. Then I added a little structure here. This was also made by Miles, a mini ocean monument. We also tried to edit the area around the structure so we get some proper guardian spawning, but unfortunately this didn't work. We tried NBT Explorer, I got some help from a friend, but unfortunately when updating the structure from 1.17 to 1.18, it didn't convert it over. So the problem is probably because the structure is in a negative coordinates and the game can't handle that. So it's a bit unfortunate, so we kind of didn't find a way yet to add a proper structure to this, but we have an Elder Guardian spawner. The Elder Guardians that are already here, added here, will also make it a bit more challenging, because up to 50 blocks away, they would give the player mining fatigue. So we got them at minus 25 approximately. So if we dig down, eventually around here we will have mining fatigue. This definitely will slow down the progression quite a bit. And I'm not quite sure how yet if we can cheese it somehow. Might look like we're gonna have to punch stone for quite some time, but I think this is a quite nice challenge. Also, yeah, worth overcoming. Then we got one more skeleton spawner here, so we can make a little XP farm. It's probably gonna be one of the first projects we do. Here I added some good items that I thought we couldn't get otherwise. So the rare music disc, one heart of the sea, so we can get a conduit and some horse armor. There's also two random donkeys at the bottom, so I'm not quite sure if those will be helpful. Let's see if I can find those. Seems like they wandered off. So there's two donkeys to be found here. Apart from that, this is pretty much it. Yeah. In case you want to get some cactus, it's also possible, but they're outside of the world border. So what you can do is you can place a dispenser on the world border, spend some TNT here on the outside. It could blow up the cactus. And then if you got an ender pearl, you could teleport ender pearl outside of the world border, pick up the cactus item and get back inside of the world border. So it's possible to get cactus as well. One more thing, at the top of the world, we got a jagged peaks biome. So starting from 294 approximately, the rest is jagged peaks. So used world edit. Change the biome, so this will give us access to snow, ice, and powder snow, for example. Right, then definitely one of the first goals, apart from getting tools, will be getting villagers, so we can buy certain things from the wandering trader using the emeralds we get from the villagers. Will also at the beginning not be possible to get every villager profession because we are lacking planks, so we couldn't make, for example, composter. Get farmers, but it's definitely possible to sell some coal to a blacksmith because we can make a blast furnace. Okay, and with those emeralds, we can buy all kinds of items from the wandering trader. I'm gonna prepare a little chest real quick so we can see what we can get from that. So if you're lucky and you got a wandering trader spawning, you might get access to the drip leaf, sugarcane, all the saplings for all the tree types, vines, the pointed dripstone, super important. In combination with the one lava source we have to make more lava using a cauldron, so we can create that obsidian portal to bring us to the nether. Then coral, which yeah is kind of important for sea pickle farming, moss also yeah for bone meal farms, then all the seed types. We can get carrots and potatoes obviously from zombies, they have a small chance to drop one, and we can also get kelp from the wandering trader. But that's all random based and might take some time until we get, for example, the really important dripstone to get to the nether. Let's check out the nether next. Okay, so here we got another mini structure, a little mini nether fortress, which was also made by Miles. Here we actually got a proper nether fortress bounding box. So that means that we get wizard skeleton spawning here, but I also added a blaze spawning here on the side. So this will be helpful as we can get access to blaze rods. So we can make a brewing stand, brew the turtle master potion, for example. This is definitely going to be important for the progression. Then at the bottom here, I'm going to remove the portal again. We got a chest, some useful items, another what can be obtained from here, and also another rare music disc. In case something actually happens to the rare flowers in the overworld, here's some backup in case maybe an Enderman picks them up. I'm not sure if they can do that, but there's also some backup for that. Okay, then we also got little patch of crimson nylium here, and on the other side I added a bit of warped nylium, so that means we can also get the nether trees by just bone milling those. Unfortunately, when we actually try to get this mini structure here, all the biomes got converted to nether wastes. So instead of having a basalt delta, we have nether wastes only, which might be not a bad thing, so we can make a proper gold farm. As you can see, lots of zombified piglins spawning here, and we will also get piglins this way, but no hoglins. So the best food source in the game, making a hoglin farm won't be doable for us. And last, I did some little adjustments to the main end island So I added Chorus Fruit, which by the way can be destroyed by the dragon. It's unfortunate, but there's plenty, so I'm quite sure there will be some leftover once we get here. So we can of course get purple blocks this way. And using the Chorus Fruit, we can also make more end crystals to resummon the dragon again if we wanted to. Then at the bottom of the end island, there's three Shulkers. So we can also make a Shulker farm using those. I briefly saw maybe it's possible to get to an end city somehow and bring a Shulker over there. But since you would be dead immediately as soon as you go this far out from the world border, I have a hard time imagining that we've actually find a solution to technically bring a Shulker over from out there. They do generate with the end cities as far as I know. Could maybe actually locate one real quick. Locate end city to see if there's Shulkers inside. Kinda curious, yeah, they would be there, but I have no idea if there is a way to get those. So that's why I just added three to the main island. This would require some either a huge glitch or some really crazy solution. Alright, so that's it for today. Hope you enjoyed episode 0 and you're just as excited as I am to play this challenge. So there will be a world download in the description if you want to play along, or you can also just watch the videos and see us struggling with this. Okay, thanks guys for watching. See you in episode 1 hopefully. Bye guys!